Welcome to RyKurkul.com. In this video, we'll talk about interesting tool that helps an organization to report or manage defect. If you're part of testing team, then this video is very helpful for you, where I will guide you end to end about this tool. During this video, I will explain you how to start creation of the account, setup of entire account itself, navigating throughout the application, as well as creation of defect. If you wanted to learn about this tool, be available from start to end of this video. Don't skip a little part of the video. You might miss interesting concept. If you have any questions or feedback, feel free to add in the comment sections. And if you wanted to learn any other tool, let me know in the comment sections. We'll be happy to create video on that tool. This tool name is Mantis, which is majorly used for incident reporting or defect reporting. If you are the testers and you found any defects, definitely you will start searching for the defect reporting tool. Sometimes it's very tedious. Share this defects on email or in Excel, where you might lose track of it. If we have a centralized place where we can manage entire defects centrally, probably it will be helpful or easy to manage entire defect cycle itself. So in this video, we'll see everything in detail. If you wanted to create accounts, basically navigate it to mantisbg.org and scroll it down, where you'll see bug tracker. Whenever you'll click, it will give you an options to create your account. Because I'm already having the account, you will see it navigates me to the account sections, where we can see entire defects, which is unassigned, reported by me, resolved, recently modified, timelines, everything is available in my view. Left section is having different views, where we can see view issues, all the issue which exist in my access. How to report a defect? We can see it here. Either you can report issues or defects here, or you can use from this button. If you wanted to see the change log is section is available here. Roadmap, where we can see the entire roadmap of our defects. If you don't have any roadmap sections, that will be not listed. In wiki sections, you can find it out detail about this product or if any additional third-party add-on is available. And in repository, you can see all the repository which is attached with this tool. It's a very important tool normally used by tester to report or assign the defect to the developer. Consider we have a testing team who is verifying mobile applications. While doing the testing, they found a very critical defect. Either they will use this type of tool where everything is managed by the tool itself centrally, where tester don't have to reach out to the development team or to the management team to get the status of the defects. If we are using email or Excel, that's where the problem exists, where every time tester has to reach out to the developer to find out the status about the defect. If development team will fix it, they will update it, and from here they start getting the updates and everyone can see about the defect itself, which is the better part of it. If you wanted to report a defect specifically, you can go to this or select this one. It will open a wizard where it will give you an options to add defect detail. What is the defect? If any functionality which is not matching with the requirements, that is treated as defect. Here, as part of category, it will ask you to select the project's name. As of now, we don't have any projects because it's my dummy account. So I've selected this options. Reproducibility. Is that defect is always or sometimes? or it's random view. This is giving the indications to the development team how they can reproduce it. What is the frequency of the defects? So based on the defect issues, you can select it always. It means it will be reproducible in every try or every instance. Sometimes it is observed, sometimes. So consider we have tried 5 or 10 times. It is just we are able to see it in out of 10, 3 or 4 times. Random, while doing the testings, if it is found randomly reproduced, then we can tag the random. Have not tried, that is also options available. Unable to reproduce or any options, you can select it. For now, I am selecting always. What is the severity of the defects? Is it features, trivial, text, tweak, minor, major, crash or blocker? Consider this is a blocker issues where after reproducing these defects, we cannot do anything. So that will become a blocker, like system crash, applications crashes frequently, or recording is not working if recording functionality is there. It means major functionality is not working itself. What is the priority of the defects? Here we have to select it. If you don't know about the priority and severity, I've already created one video on it. Make sure to watch that video as well from my software testing playlist, which will help you to understand each and everything in detail. For now, I'm selecting high priority and proceeding further. Selecting the profile in which platforms it was able to receive, I'm just writing UAT. Operating system, consider we have Windows. OS version, what will be the OS version? I'm just giving for the time being 2.0. What will be the product version? Here I'm selecting randomly anything. Totally depending on the product's details, you can select it. Important part is title or summary. Title should be written in such a way where by reading this title, any can understand what is the exact issues. Give a short and crystal clear title so that it will create impressions on the developers or those who are reading these defects. They will be able to understand it by just reading the title itself. For reproducing these defects, definitely they need some steps, but for the title should be clear. Normally, when we have bunch of projects which is running in the organizations, that point of time, expectations from you is to add the navigation as well. If you have just 1 or 2 projects, it's not required, but if organization is having a lot of projects running, you can follow some patterns while writing it. Consider the pattern is project name, then the functionality, and then version. After that, you can define the title of it. This will indicate what will the project name, then the functions, then the versions, and accordingly, they can search for it. So it is highlighting majorly. If you don't want to mention the version, that is also fine. We have already selected in project version itself. It's not mandatory, but it varies from companies to company what standards they are following it. Sometimes they are also expecting you to enter, it will be reported from QA or UAT. That's the differentiation they wanted to make it. As of now, let's go ahead with this. Where we are calling as recording is not working. In descriptions, it's mandatory to follow some etiquettes. Sometimes testers are writing single line descriptions, which will create a lot of confusions. Developer might reach out to you several times. Even the analyst who is analyzing these defects, they will also eat a lot of your time. To save those multiple to and fro, it's better to include detailed descriptions about the defect. Normally, I follow one pattern. So this pattern, if you'll follow it, probably it will be helpful for reader to understand defect perfectly and they will not eat your time. If you're using any other pattern, feel free to add in the comment sections. It might helpful to a viewer who can have multiple strategies to be followed while writing the descriptions. So this pattern normally I have used, it is working very effectively, where developer or analyst will not reach out to you for further details unless and until they won't have any extreme conditions. So pattern which I follow is majorly to start with preconditions. Just add the preconditions, what preconditions you want to add, like if after having one recording this feature is not working, that's the preconditions, or login page will be available, or you have already logged in, those type of scenario. Then here you can add steps to reproduce, where you can define detailed steps starting from the navigations, initial navigation. Consider you are at home page and you have to navigate it to the recording and then start the recording. So first you have to click on home, then click on recording, and once you'll enter into the recording container, then you will get an options to start the recording. But while clicking on the recording, this recording is not starting. So entirely everything you have to mention it, like navigating from recording container, click record, and this feature is not working. After that, you can add actual issue, expected result, or maybe you can just replicate to actual result, and then finally you can add expected results. So actual result is what's the error you are facing and what could be the expected. So for this case, expected result will be recording, so start immediately. And after that, if you have any additional notes, you can specify it to here. So if you'll follow this pattern, what happened after reading the steps or descriptions, they will not reach out to you for multiple things. Description is available here, exactly same things in Mantis. We can add it to steps to reproduce. So if you'll remove the steps, that is also fine, but you can add it here. If you're using any other defect reporting tools like Jira, Rally, Redmine, normally it will not give you a two different options. Within the summary, within the descriptions, you have to add everything. But for Mantis, it's better part where it is giving you an options to add steps to reproduce. If you have any additional informations, you can just add it here. Along with that, if you have any screenshots or issue recording, you can attach it directly to here. And post that, you can select public because you wanted to tag the person. Report stay if you want, or maybe you can directly click on issues, submit issues, I mean. Once you'll click on submit issues, this issue is created successfully. If you want to monitor, click on monitor, and where you have this issue will get notified to you whenever you wanted to see the results. Jump to history if you wanted to see any history related to this issues, that is also available. Now, after creating this defect, you can see defect ID is this one. What is the projects? Then category, public, when we have submitted it, what is the detailed steps? And along with that, if you have any attachments, you can add it. If you forget to add anything while creating the defects, you'll also have options to do edit, where you can attach any attachments. After that, if you wanted to see the detail issue view, where you can see all the issues which is reported by you, assigned and resolved. Any issues which you have created older, that is listed here. Exactly same thing, you can see it here, but you might find it out for the updates like status. This issue is resolved now. Who has resolved? All those steps are mentioned. If they have added any comments, that is also there. At any point of time, you want to clone this issues where you found this issue is reproducible in some other version. Just you can clone it. Click on clone, where it will open the wizard where you can set your parameters like priority, severity, platform, versions, everything. You can modify it and then click on submit issues. The new issues with new issue ID will be generated successfully. That's how we can create defects. And initially we have started with Mantis setup as well as Mantis account creations. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. And action for you. If you have already used this tool, share your feedback about this tool, how you love it. If you're using any other tool which you found much more helpful or much more useful for the tester to report a defect, feel free to add in the comment sections. We'll be happy to see your tool name, and this might help to other viewers who can learn more from you. That's all from today. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in next video.